honored to introduce you to our three guests this afternoon. They are very talented. They have a lot of wisdom, and they sound really, really, really good. I wish we could have had them perform here on the set, but I saw them before in a benefit concert, and this time there's no stopping them. They're still touring, and they're still having a concert for a cause, this time another cause. On Sunday, I'll let them explain that to you today on the show. Welcome the Hiroshima Band, or three of the band members at least. Kimo, hello, welcome
to
the show.
Nice to be here.
June and Danny, hello and welcome to you as well.
Hi,
great to
thank
be
you.
Here.
Hiroshima was formed in 1976, and until now, all through the years, you've just been playing, touring, performing. What do you think is the secret to your longevity?
Well, I think, like we were talking earlier, it's a concept that the band had, you know, and actually Dan and June started, you know, with this concept in the mid-70s. Mm-hmm. So I think that's what keeps us going, and, you know.
June, what is the concept when you started?
The concept was actually, there are different folds of the visions that we had. One of them was to incorporate Asian instrumentation, especially like the koto and taiko, shakuhachi, the woodwind instrument. But also behind that was more meaning and sense of breaking the stereotypes of Asian America here in the United States, because there's been such negative images there as well. And then also the message of peace and always trying to promote and going back to the heart of the people.
I guess that is good. That is such a wonderful message. And I would say that perhaps in the late 70s when you formed this, it's probably not as easy as some artists have it now. I would think that in the 70s, people were more mainstream. America was more resistant to Asian influences, right? Did you have any experience about that?
Well, I mean, when we got started, there were no Asian American bands at all. So they didn't even know where to categorize us, you know. What are they? You know, how do we market them? There was no precedent. Mm-hmm. Luckily, we had a few people in the record company who believed in us. Larkin Arnold was one. And he got us our foot in the door. He was the one who believed in us. There were a lot of people at our own record company who thought we would fail. Mm-hmm. So it was a tough road, definitely.
What do you think, June, since you started this and you started that concept, what do you think was the biggest struggle of the band in what, 20 years?
I think it's always constant struggle, you know, because every time you always hit something, as the longer you go, there are going to be more bumps. There'll be good things and bad. It's always the yin and the yang. But the most important thing is that you learn and you grow. Mm-hmm. And if we could keep that, because a lot of times there's so much discouraging things. Like right now, the music industry, I mean, with downloading on the one hand, we might as well give up. I mean, we're talking about how when you sell CDs, we're right. talking small change. We're
right.
not talking, you know, like you sold a house or mm-hmm. those kinds of money. We're not talking about that. But again, it's going back to your true passion mm-hmm. and being able to always be creative mm-hmm. and that we have the voice and to take advantage of that. And those are the things that keep us going.
Right. And on Sunday, Hiroshima is using their voice for a great cause. We've talked about them before, A3M. There's going to be a fundraiser on Sunday. Can you tell us a little bit more?
Well, it's for the Asian bone marrow transplant, mm-hmm. And it's a benefit for that, mm-hmm. to raise money for the community.
I know that annually they raise money to raise awareness.
Right.
Because what is needed from the community?
Number one, they need donors for bone marrow, but also, if you're chicken about that, then at least donate money and go, and you can do it by either just making a strict donation or go to the concert and support the event and support us. But basically, read up on it. Go to the A3M site mm-hmm. and see what it's about, because it's a beautiful, you know, it's a beautiful organization. It's needed. It's helping other people out.
And I always say this, you're getting a twofer, guys, because you are getting one to help these people who need bone marrow transplant. You're helping A3M. You're helping the cause. And two, you're getting wonderful entertainment. What's in store for your fans and for people that are maybe just discovering you now at the concert on Sunday?
Well, we're playing a lot of music from our new CD, Departure. So they'll get to see a lot of that.
And we have a great master, Kenny Endo, with us, taiko master from Hawaii, who would be playing with us.
What do you think is, how would you describe the sound of Hiroshima?
Well, it's a blend of a lot of different things, mm-hmm. you know, and with June and her koto, which is, you know, the stringed instrument that sounds like a harp that she plays, mm-hmm. and the taiko drums from Japan, big sounding drums, mm-hmm. and then we kind of weave that in with our Western take on music,
right.
and the Eastern inflections of music.
So it's a fusion. Would
yes.
you say it's like a jazz contemporary fusion? Or?
Right, because it's a reflection of being from Los Angeles, growing up in LA, so mm-hmm. you have R&B, you have jazz, you have salsa, you have a little bit of, you know, a funk, we have yeah. a little bit of, you
I mean,
know.
Our taste in the
right.
band is very eclectic.
Okay.
So we ran the gamut from, it could be a rock kind of vibe,
yeah.
you
right.
know, or jazz or R&B.
But, you know, we can exhaust the dictionary looking for a word to describe them. The only way to appreciate them is to hear them. Here's a sample, more power to you. Watch them on Sunday. Information on the screen. This has been Janelle Sawyer-Kubelbein in Los Angeles. Have a great weekend. I'll see you on Monday.